Oh, good day sa atin mga ka-everything. It's me, Sir Teng, at kayo'y nanonood sa aking channel, Sir Teng Vlogs. Kung ayaw nyo na pong manood, mag-subscribe na lang po kayo. For today's video, tayo po ay mag-aaral ng Philosophy of Education, ayan, or Philosophical Foundation of Education. Our professorial lecturer here is Dr. Reynaldo Francisco Jr. Shout out sa iyo, sir. So, let's start. Okay. I am your discussant for this day. Okay. Let's have Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi, born on January 12, 1746 at Zurich, Switzerland, and died on February 17, 1827 in Brough, Switzerland. Who was Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi? Sino nga ba si Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi? Okay. He is a Swiss social reformer and educator, ayan, known as the father of modern education. The modern era of education started with him, and his spirit and ideas led to the great educational reforms in Europe in the 19th century. So sabi dito, he was the father of modern education. Then, it led Europe, ayan, to be the great educational reforms by the year or by the century or 19th century. So, si Heinrich Pestalozzi is a romanticist. So, ganun niya kamahal ang education. Okay, what was Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi known for? Pestalozzi saw teaching as a subject worth studying in its own right, and he is therefore known as the father of pedagogy, or the method and practice of teaching, especially as an academic subject or theoretical concept. So, doon tayo nagbe-base sa more on methods, practice of teaching, especially doon sa ating mga subject areas or theoretical concept. He caused education to become a separate branch of knowledge alongside politics and other recognized area of knowledge. So, hiniwalay niya, ayan, ang education, ayan, as a branch of knowledge, ano, kabilang na dito yung branch ng knowledge natin, which is the politics and other recognized area or areas of knowledge. What was Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi known for? Okay. Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi was a Swiss pedagogue and educational reformer who exemplified Romanticism in his approach. He founded several educational institutions both in German and French-speaking regions of Switzerland and wrote many works explaining his revolutionary modern principles of education. Sabi ko nga kanina, ayan, he is a romanticist. So, gumagamit siya ng exemplified romanticism in his approach in education. Ibig sabihin, gumagana ang isip, ang puso, at ang mga ginagawa. Kaya marami siyang naisulat, ayan, with regards to revolutionary modern principles of education. What is Pestalozzi's theory of education? Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi believed in the ability of every individual human being to learn, ayan, and in the right of every individual to education. Kaya nga ngayon, pre-education tayo, ano po? From preschool, ayan, elementary, junior high school, senior high school, ayan, even in college, you know, we have the public university. So, parang nandoon din ang galing yung, ayan, yung idea ng education ay kailangan matuto. Ayan. It is a right of every individual to have a good education. He believed that it was the duty of society, ayan, duty of the government to put this right into practice. His beliefs led to education becoming democratic, so pagiging malaya. In Europe, education became available for everyone. Kaya nga nasabi ko kanina, siguro na-adapt na rin ito ng ating educational system. Kasi even sa college, ay we have the free education. Pestalozzi was particularly concerned about the condition of the poor. Some of them did not go to school. If they did, the school education was often useless for their needs. He wanted to provide them with an education which would make them independent and able to improve their own lives. So noong mga nakaraang pangapanahon, ang pag-aaral ay para lang sa mayaman. Kaya nagkaroon ng reform si Pestalozzi, kaya naging pre-education ang pag-aaral sa Europe. Pestalozzi was particularly concerned about the condition of the poor, sabi ko nga kanina. Ayan. So meron siyang puso para sa mga mahihirap. Ayan. He wanted to provide them with an education would make them independent. Ma-provide lahat sa kanila ang pangangailangan. Ayan, magkaroon ng tamang edukasyon para sila ay mamuhay. Ayan, makatayo sa sariling paa to become an independent human being and able to improve their own lives. So sabi nga, pag pinanganak kang mahirap, ayan, kasalanan na natin na tayo ay mamatay ng mahirap. So, kailangan ma-improve natin yung sarili natin as a human being. Pestalozzi believed that education should develop the powers of head, heart, and hands. He believed that this would help create individuals who are capable of knowing what is right and what is wrong, and of acting according to this knowledge. Thus, the well-being of every individual could be improved and each individual could become a responsible citizen. So, hindi lang dapat natin ginagamit ang ating talino, dapat ginagamit din natin ang ating puso at ang ating, ayan, paggawa, pagkilos. So, we have the head, the heart, and the hands. Ibig sabihin na ating pag-aaral ay kailangan isinasaisip, isinasapuso, at isinasagawa. So, ganun yung ating nais patunguhin, ayan, ni Heinrich Pestalozzi sa kanyang reform on education. Okay. Thus, the well-being of every individual could be improved and each individual could become a responsible citizen. He believed that empowering and enabling every individual in this way was the only way to improve society and bring peace and security to the world. His aim was for a complete theory of education that would lead to a practical way of bringing happiness to humankind. So ganun na no yung kanyang reforma. Kailangan ma-improve in every individual para maging, ayan, magkaroon sa lipunan ng payapa at makasiguro tayo na ayan na yung edukasyon ay para sa lahat. Ayan. It will lead to a practical way of bringing happiness to humankind. Sino ba naman ang gustong ayan, hindi masaya no na siya ay nag-i-improve in his education or in her education. Kaya kailangan tayo ay nag-aaral. What is Pestalozzi's theory of education? Okay, Pestalozzi believed in the ability of every individual human being to learn in the right of every individual to education. He believed that it was a duty of society to put this right into practice. His beliefs led to education becoming democratic in Europe. Education became available for everyone. Okay. What is the contribution of Johann Heinrich Pestalozzi to education? So, ano nga bang contribution? Pestalozzi's approach has had a massive influence on education. Ayan. For example, his influence as well as his relevance to education today is clear in the importance now put on, ayan, the interests and needs of the child. Ibig sabihin, hindi lang nakakulong sa iisang classroom ang mga bata ngayon. So, nag-explore sila ng maraming bagay. Ayan. Dangan lamang tayo ay dumaan sa pandemic. Ayan, talagang nasubok yung ating kakayanan sa pagtuturo. Ayan. During the online, during the modular, distance learning. So, self-paced learning ang mga bata, no? Pero, unti-unti nagbabalik tayo doon sa hindi lang nakakulong ang ating mga students. Ayan. Na-explore nila yung kanilang interests and needs, ano, with regards in education. Okay? It must be a child-centered rather than the teacher-centered approach to teaching. So, hindi lang dapat nakasentro sa guro ang ating pag-aaral ngayon. Kumbaga, nakasentro ang pag-aaral mismo sa ating mga estudyante. So, we need to have a child-centered, ayan, schooling. So, nandoon yung ideas, nasa kanila yung ideas. Kaya nga ang tawag sa atin ngayon is the facilitator of learning. Ayan, to be active rather than passive participation in the learning experiences. Kaya may mga performance tasks, mga activities na ginagawa. To be the students will able to be on the active participation. Ayan. So, meron tayong mga minsan pinagagawa sa halimbawa sa English, we have the drama. Sa PE, ine-execute nila yung sayaw. Ayan. Ayan. Sa mathematics, ayan, nagagamit ko rin yung ability sa vlogging. So, yung mga bata, mga estudyante, on their performance tasks, gumagawa din sila ng active participation with in-explain nila yung isang lesson through video blogging. Okay, the freedom of the child based on his or her natural development balance with the self-discipline to function well as individual in society. The child having direct experience of the world and the use of natural objects in teaching. So, mas maganda daw na na-experience ng bata yung pag-aaral. Kaya nga tayo, meron tayo sa science, nag-experiment, ayan. Ganun din sa other fields of education, ano, sa other subjects po. Cooperation between the school and the home and between parents and teachers. Ayan. So, kasama na natin yung mga magulang. Kaya nga meron tayong tinatawag na PTA. Ayan, Parents Teacher Association. Sa ating mga eskwelahan. Ano? Kumbaga, collaborative effort tayo with the cooperation of the school, the home, between parents and teachers. Kung ano bang kalalagayan ng ating mga estudyante sa loob ng paaralan. Ano ba yung sitwasyon nila sa bahay? Ayan. Napakahalaga nung magkakaroon tayo ng ayan, communication with the parents. The importance of an all-round education, an education of the head, the heart, and the hands, but which is led by the heart. Ayan. Kailangan yung ating pagtuturo. Ayan. Pagtuturong may puso. The use of systemized subjects of instruction, which are also carefully graduated and illustrated. Learning which is cross-circular and includes a varied school life. Education which puts emphasis on how things are taught as well as what is taught. Authority based on love, not fear. So, kailangan ang ating pagtuturo, hindi tayo or hindi natatakot ang ating estudyante sa atin bagkus minamahal nila ang ating mga itinuturo. Ano? Okay, next is Maria Montessori. Okay? Next topic, next to my topic is Maria Montessori. Sino nga ba si Maria Montessori? Maria Montessori was born on August 31, 1870 in the provincial town of Chiaravale, Italy. Ayan. Her father was a financial manager for state-run industry. Her mother raised in a family that prized education, was well-schooled, and an avid reader, unusual for Italian women of the time. The same thirst for knowledge took root in young Maria, and she immersed herself in many fields of study before creating the educational method that bears her name. Kaya nga, mayroon sa ating mga Montessori school, ano po? Ayan, dito sa Pilipinas. So, inspired by, ayan, Maria Montessori. Maria Montessori was an Italian physician. Okay? She is a doctor, educator, and innovator. A claim for educational method that builds on the way children learn naturally. So, beginning in early childhood of Maria Montessori, yan, she lived in Rome, growing up in a paradise of libraries, museums, and fine schools. She opened the first Montessori school, ayan, which is called the Casa dei Bambini, or Children's House. Ayan, in Rome on January 6, 1907. Subsequently, she traveled the world and wrote extensively about her approach to education, attracting many devotees. And there are now thousands of Montessori schools in countries worldwide. Ibig sabihin, kumalat yung approach. Ayan, ng pagiging Montessori school, inspired by Maria Montessori, ano? All over the world. Ayan, umabot din sa Pilipinas po, ano? So, breaking barriers in education, Maria was a sterling student, confident, ambitious, and unwilling to be limited by traditional expectations for women. At age 13, she entered an all-boys technical institute to prepare for a career in engineering. Ayan, ano? So, napakatalino ng ating Maria Montessori. Ayan. At the age of 13, nasa technical institute niya siya for career in engineering. In time, however, she changed her mind, deciding to become a doctor instead. Ayan. She applied to the University of Rome's medical program but was rejected. Maria took additional courses to better prepare her for entrance to the medical school and preserve. With great effort, she gained admittance, opening the door a bit wider for future women in the field. Ibig sabihin, nung una, pumasok siya pero siya ay na-reject. Ano po? So, ganoon naman talaga sa buhay. Minsan, kailangan magkaroon tayo ng rejection. Okay, let us continue my report. So, Maria Montessori, yan. When she graduated from medical school in 1896, Maria was among Italy's first female physicians. So, isa siya sa mga naunang babaeng doktor, ano, or physicians sa Italy. Though she was not the first female medical school graduate, as reported by many of her biographers, it does not detract from her accomplishment. Defying conventions, norms, and expectations to successfully make her way in this rigorous, male-dominated field required tremendous strength, dedication, and perseverance. So, kahit hindi naman siya yung nauna, pero pinatunayan ni Maria Montessori na, yan, enough yung kanyang nalalaman, yan, sabi dito tremendous strength, dedication, and perseverance. So, birth of a movement. Maria's early medical practice focused on psychiatry. So, nanggagamot siya sa mentally incapacitated, mga ganyan, or mental health, with regards to the mental health. She later developed an interest in education, attending classes on pedagogy, and immersing herself in educational theory. So, nagpoko siya sa psychiatry, dun nga nalaman niya or na-develop niya yung interest niya sa education. That leads her to herself in educational theory. Her studies led her to observe and call into question the prevailing methods of teaching children with intellectual and developmental disabilities. So, ano ba yung maituturo? Ayan. Or way ng pagtuturo sa isang bata na mayroong intellectual or developmental disabilities. Ayan. Yung mga mentally challenged nating mga estudyante. The opportunity to improve on these methods came in 1900s when she was appointed co-director of a new training institute for special education teachers. So, doon, nagkaroon tayo ng special education. Ayan. So, na-train siya as a special education teacher. Ano? Maria approached the task scientifically, carefully, observing and experimenting to learn which teaching methods work best. So, ano ba yung magandang methods or strategies or approach para sa mga SPED students? Ano? With their special needs. Many of the children made unexpected gains and the program was proclaimed a success. So, sa ginawa ng Maria Montessori, ayan, it was a success. So, magandang ano yun, ano? Simula para sa kanya. In 1907, Maria accepted a challenge to open a full-day childcare center or a daycare center in San Lorenzo, a poor inner city district of Rome. The students were underserved youngsters ages 3 to 7. So, ano natin ito? Kung tayo ay nag-aaral, ito ay preschool, okay, daycare hanggang grade 1 or 2, who were left to their own devices while their parents went out to work. This center, the first of its kind in the nation and high-quality learning environment, became the first Casa dei Bambini. Ayan. Yan yung naunang eskwelahan or Montessori school, ano po, which is the Casa dei Bambini. The children were unruly at first, so hindi sumusunod, but soon showed great interest in working with puzzles, learning to prepare meals, and manipulating learning materials Maria had designed. So, sa una, syempre, ganyan naman talaga ang mga bata sa una, sa pasukan. Ayan, unruly or with regards to their behavior, meron silang misbehavior. So, luckily, soonest, ayan, nag-work out naman sila, ano, with the learning materials na na-design ni Maria Montessori. She observed how the children absorb knowledge from their surroundings, essentially teaching themselves. Then, continue tayo. The children were unruly at first, syempre, yun nga. Using scientific observation experience gained from her earlier work with young children, Maria designed learning materials in a classroom environment that fostered the children's natural desire to learn and provided freedom for them to choose their own materials. So, yung pag sinabi nating Montessori approach, ayan, lahat ng maaaring possibility na materials ay ibibigay sa mga bata. Ano? So, malapit ang loob ni Maria Montessori sa mga SPED students as well as sa mga bata. Kasi nga, ang mga preschoolers natin or graders, kailangan dyan nahuhubog yung foundation ano ng pag-aaral or the foundation of education para as we go along on their high school life or college life ay handa na sila on the facing their responsibilities sa pagiging isang professional. So kailangan from the very start of the schooling and mabuild na sa mga bata yung foundation of education. So that's all for this day. I hope you learned something from me. Thanks for watching and listening. I am Mr. Mark Vincent M. Ripalda and saying goodbye. Thank you po.